It's summer, and you've just been bitten by a mosquito. You've been listening to the news, and you've been hearing talk about the West Nile virus in your area. So what is it? Is it something that you need to worry about? What are the symptoms? And what do you do if you get it? And most importantly, how do you keep from getting it? To find the answers to these questions, keep watching. Welcome to Family Med, your medical home for practical and accurate information to help your family make healthy decisions. This is the channel that focuses on bringing better health to your home. If you're new here, let me introduce myself. I'm Dr. Eric Richardson, and my passion is helping you cut through all the health information clutter on the internet so you can have the knowledge that you need to live a healthier life. So today, we're going to be addressing some of the concerns and worries you have about the West Nile virus. This is a sickness that we've been hearing more and more about. It's something that you can catch just by being bitten by a mosquito. And we all can relate to that because who hasn't been bit before? But before we talk about whether it's something you need to worry about, let's just talk briefly about what it is. The West Nile virus is an infection that primarily affects birds, but it can be spread to humans and other animals through mosquitoes that have previously bitten an infected bird. It was first discovered in Uganda in 1937. But it's been spreading throughout the world and the United States specifically since 1999. Human cases have been reported in all 48 of the contiguous United States. In the US, it typically lasts from the summer into the early fall. Now, remember, I told you that I was going to let you know if it is something you need to worry about. Well, the great news about the West Nile virus is that most people infected with it never develop symptoms and will not know they even have the virus. It typically remains in the body for a few days until the immune system fights it off. But if that was the case all the time, then we wouldn't be talking about it, would we? So, if for some reason your body doesn't fight off the symptoms, you'll typically start within 2 to 15 days with when you were bit by the infected mosquito. So what are those symptoms then? Well, of those bitten, around 25% will develop what we call West Nile fever. This tends to be a short-lived illness typically presented with fever, headache, tiredness, back pain, muscle aches, decreased appetite, and a possible rash. Sometimes you can get symptoms such as nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, and abdominal pain. Now, do any of these symptoms sound like any other illness you've had? Well, of course they do. Most of your viral illnesses tend to present this way. However, you don't get the typical nasal or respiratory symptoms that we see with a cold virus. Now, these symptoms can last for anywhere from a few days to several weeks. More recent studies show that it can take up to a month for all the symptoms to disappear. Now, one common symptom for most people who get it, though, is they feel really tired for several weeks afterwards. For these type of symptoms, most people don't feel sick enough that they decide to go visit the doctor. Usually, you can just treat the symptoms with things like rest, lots of fluids, and medications such as acetaminophen or even ibuprofen. So by now you may be thinking, well, then if that's all it is, then why are we even worried about it? Well, the reason is that there are a small percentage of people, maybe 1% of those infected, that can go on to develop more significant illness. In these people, the virus infects the brain and spinal cord, which we call either an encephalitis, or infection of the brain, or meningitis, which is an infection of the lining around the brain. This can happen to anybody, but it's most common in those who are over 60 years old, those who are battling more advanced cancers, and those who are taking immunosuppressant medications. Okay, so signs of more severe disease would include headache, fever, disorientation, convulsions, muscle weakness, coma, and even paralysis. These symptoms can last for weeks, and in some can even be left with permanent neurologic damage. Rarely, people have even died from this. Like I said before, it's not common to have severe symptoms, so I don't want you to overly worry about it. In fact, remember, most people don't even have any symptoms. However, it's always good to protect yourself, and especially do so if you're at higher risk for the complications from it. So how do you know for sure that you've been infected with the West Nile virus? Well, the only way to really know is to have a blood test. And honestly, we don't do a lot of testing for this. It typically isn't necessary. However, if you're having more significant symptoms, especially the severe ones that we just described, it's important that you get to your doctor, or if even needed, the emergency room and be tested. Now, through blood tests or in severe cases, you can even test the spinal fluid. We can get a more sure diagnosis, although it often doesn't show up in the blood for even a week after being infected. Unfortunately, even if you do have it, there isn't much more that can be done for it other than what we call supportive care. Because of that, it is key that we work mostly on prevention. So what can you do to avoid getting the virus? Well, it's pretty simple. Don't get bit by mosquitoes, especially for those who live in an area that the West Nile virus is more prevalent. Remember, mosquitoes are most active at dawn and at dusk, so you need to be most careful around these times. Use a good insect repellent, wear pants and long-sleeved shirts if you're likely to be bit. Also, prevent mosquitoes from populating by draining areas of standing water, like buckets, bird baths, gutters, wading pools, and pet dishes where mosquitoes frequently lay eggs. So hopefully through this, you've learned that the West Nile virus isn't something you need to be overly worried about. However, being aware of the significant symptoms that can present and taking measures to prevent from being bit are some simple, common sense things that you can do to avoid this potentially serious disease. Well, that's about it for the West Nile virus. Hopefully you found the information we presented today useful. If you did, don't forget to like, subscribe, and even hit that notification button, as well as share it with your friends. Now remember, my purpose in sharing this information for you is to educate you on things that you can think about in trying to make decisions in your own health. And no way should it be taken as direct medical advice to you and in your own situation. So please consult your own doctor for concerns regarding your specific situation. If you want to hear some other great advice about when you should go to the doctor, why don't you check out my video on when you should be seen for your sore throat and when it's okay to stay home. Click here to see what YouTube thinks you would be most interested in. Try it out, see if they're right. So until next time, this is Family Med with Dr. Richardson. And remember, don't forget to take care of your body, because it's the only one you have.